In this video, we're going to take a look at function inverses and see how we can identify them as a mapping. Now, we already know that a function takes an element in the domain and maps it to an element in the range. Let's use the function x squared. Then what this function does is it maps 2 in the domain to 4 in the range. Then the point 2, 4 is a point on this function. What the inverse does is it maps that point in the range back to the point in the domain. So it would map 4 back to 2. Now, since our function is x squared, our inverse needs to undo that, so we could use g of x equals square root of x. That maps 4 back to 2, and now 4, 2 is a point on g of x, just flipped from the point that we had on f of x. If you recall, it was 2, 4. And our domain and range would be switched. That's another property of inverses. So now we have the domain of g of x is what the range was of f of x. And the range of g of x is what the domain was of f of x. So it swaps the domain and the range. Now let's recap what we did. We took an element in the domain, 2, and we plugged it into f. And that mapped it to 4. Then we took 4 and input it into g, which mapped it back to 2. And so what we get as a composition is that g of f of 2 equals 2. So notice that when we used an input of 2, input it to our function, and then input that output into the inverse, we got back to where we started. That will always be a property of inverse functions because they undo each other. We will always get back to where we started when we compose inverse functions.